25,600 minutes.
How do you measure your life? Do you measure it in the things you did? Or do you measure it in love?
It's not about drag queens or AIDS or whatever. It's about people and about commitment and about love.
I think Rent is about joy. It's about looking at death and saying, no, I'm going to live and I'm going to have a wonderful time.
It's profoundly touching people's lives, including our own.
I'm going to be alive and I'm going to celebrate life. That really probably is what Rent is. It's a celebration of living.
Jonathan Larson, I think, really wanted to leave people with a gift with this show. I think it was very, very important to him to present a world of people who are very different, very diverse, in the face of very dire circumstances, being able to come together and give each other true love and support.
Is the time 1-866-823-1077 on this Tuesday afternoon, and we are so delighted to have Chris Lockwood with us. Chris is the director of marketing at Manchester's Historic Palace Theater, where the Tony Award-winning Broadway musical, Tony Award Pulitzer Prize-winning musical Rent, opens this Friday night, all part of the Citizens Bank Performing Arts Series. And Chris, welcome to the Pulse once again. Great to have you with us.
Thanks for having me. It's great to be back here on the Pulse and talking about some exciting stuff happening at the Palace Theater.
And a lot of exciting things are happening at the Palace Theater, starting on Friday night with the opening of Rent on Friday the 13th. And Rent, for those who don't know, a very unique and groundbreaking musical, and actually based on the opera La Boheme.
Yeah, it is. It's definitely, it changed the face of the traditional musical. When you think of show tunes, maybe something that the older generations are singing, Oklahoma or The Music Man. And then Jonathan Larson came out with something so different with Rent. And it caught on because I think people just identify with the messages that it's in there. The music is amazing, and it's just a wonderful show. If you know it, you love it, and you're going to want to come and see it. If you haven't seen it, we've got plenty of glimpses of it on our social media, on Facebook, to give you a taste of what you're going to see on stage.
You just heard some of the music, and of course, music from Rent and Seasons of Love, which you heard as the signature song from that show. But the music, as you said, is incredible. It came out, opened in 1996 on Broadway, and people at that time, I remember, were saying this is the greatest musical score since the 50s. I mean, really, the score is just incredible, as you pointed out by Jonathan Larson, who unfortunately died unexpectedly the morning of Rent's first preview performance. Unbelievable, but just an incredible, groundbreaking musical, and it'll open Friday night at the Palace Theater. It's won Tony Awards, the Pulitzer Prize, and deals with friends in New York City's East Village, tackling issues like addiction, poverty, AIDS, and the love they had for each other, and really embraced by theater audiences of all ages.
Absolutely. And I part of the mystique of Rent is Jonathan Larson passing away before he saw the finished product,
right,
and was able to have an audience to give back to him and give him energy and thank him for this incredible piece of art. And that's one of the things that's not lost on me as, trying to market this show, the cast that we have and what they go through to put this show on. I feel obligated to deliver the biggest audience possible just to give back to them and say thank you. seeing them in rehearsals. And by the way, they've only been at this 10 days. Mm-hmm. It's going to be 10 rehearsal days until open night that they've been going at this. But they're all professionals. We get them from New York, yeah. And they're used to this kind of thing. And most of them have some history with Rent. But just seeing them, and if you could imagine, even being a professional actor, being in a scene where you're holding someone that you love as they're dying, and then having the director say, "Cut, wait, we're gonna change this around, we're gonna do this a little different," and stay in the moment and go right back to that feeling. I was in taking pictures and video to help promote the show, and I was a basket case. I was crying. It stirs up emotions in you, and that's, it's so powerful. It's gonna come across on the stage, and if you're coming to see Rent, be ready for a really emotional evening.
Yeah, absolutely so. And I think a lot of people will be of all ages. I mean, it just transcends the generations. It really does. And you talk about directing it, Carl Rajat, who has been at the Palace for many, many years and has been involved in some great, great productions over the years at the Palace, will be directing this as well.
Yeah, Carl is absolutely amazing. When people talk about the Palace Theater, a lot of times they say it, oh, it's a gem of New Hampshire, it's this great treasure we have. Carl is our treasure. Everything goes through his vision, and what he's able to do with these casts to get them to understand his vision and put out a Broadway quality show right here in Manchester. It's just absolutely astounding. And he's very much wants to show the process. He's not someone like, you can't see this yet. It's not done. It's not perfect. He wants to show behind the scenes. He wants to show the whole creative process, and how fast the sets get built and the costumes are designed and the choreography and the music and just how quickly things go up. You would be amazed at opening night to think, well, how did they do this? You would just assume that it's a tour, and a lot of people do. They don't realize that we are an in-house production theater, and tremendous kudos to Carl for being able to pull that off.
Unbelievable, and I have been able to see what they've done over the years, and it's truly remarkable, and Carl has done an incredible job. And, all the sets are built right there at the Palace. Everything is done at the Palace Theater. Carl, also a great guy to put a cast together. I've seen it many, many times. And just give us a little background on how that is done, how the cast is put together by Carl.
Well, we have a casting call, and usually Carl will go down to New York, because that's where the talent is. And we'll have anywhere from 300 to 400 actors and dancers come out over several days, and Carl will sift through them. And he's got this in his office. He's got this big board, and you'll see him, start to put headshots up, and you can see him working out in his head who's going to play what character. One of the things Carl is known for is his choreography. His dancing background is amazing. So no matter what the show is at the Palace Theater, the people on stage, they're going to be very good dancers. And he's going to push to get the most out of them. It's just like any other Broadway theater. We get the best talent. We bring them up here to New Hampshire, and the only thing that's different is our prices are a lot more reasonable than Broadway.
That they are. I can attest to that. That is so true. I mean, it's a slice of Broadway in downtown Manchester, and a tremendous lineup this year of talent. If you go online to the Palace's website, which is a terrific website, palacetheater.org, right?
That is correct.
And you can take a look at clips from Rent and the rehearsals, the cast, and this is a top-notch cast, as Chris just mentioned. Broadway talent, some people from Broadway, off-Broadway, and also some great local talent sprinkled in as well.
Yeah, we've got a couple of people. I believe there's three locals who are in the performance, and they do a lot of stuff in the theater as part of the theater company. And also interesting, we've got Cail, who plays Roger. Mm-hmm. He was born and raised in Manchester. He made his debut in the second grade on our stage as the Music Man, and then moved on, pursued his dream, and now so this is a homecoming for him. So that's kind of a nice story to go along with the whole theme of Rent.
Yeah, that is very true. And as you said, many of these performers, whether they be of the Broadway performers that we've talked about, or the local performers, have been involved in this show before. But it always amazes me, no matter what the show is, how incredibly quickly it comes together. I mean, you say they've been working at 10 days at this point?
No, it'll be a total of 10 days.
A total of 10 days. Not even 10 days yet, but by the time Thursday, when you have the dress rehearsal on Thursday, then it'd be 10 days, which is just incredible. I mean, it truly is, and I think it speaks to the talent that is involved in this show, and obviously the directorial ability of Carl Rajat, no question about that. And how about we talked about the sets. I mean, that's another aspect of it that a lot of people don't think about. They're not shipped in from anywhere else. They're constructed, put together right there at the palace.
Yeah, and that's happening while we speak. There's a lot going on at the palace right now. There's kind of these two dramatic evolutions that are going on. The cast is rehearsing and working with the band, and the show itself is taking shape, but the Palace Theater has some major renovations that are going on right now. A brand new sprinkler system, a new fly system. Right now, we're having the sound re-engineered for this show specifically. So if you walked into the Palace Theater right now, you would see pipes and people painting and plastic covering the seats. And, for a lot of people, that would probably freak them out and think, there's no way you're going to be ready in 2 days for a dress rehearsal. And, that's just business as usual for us.
The show must go on, right?
Absolutely.
Chris Lockwood, the director of marketing at Manchester's Palace Theater, and great to have them on and as a sponsor here on the Pulse of our Hot Ticket Tuesdays. And during the course of the Palace Theater season, we'll be giving away tickets to various shows as well. And what's the new fly system? What is that? A sprinkler system, I understand. I'm sure most people do. But what's the new fly system?
So the fly system is anytime any of the sets or the lighting or anything gets moved up and down and flies up so that you don't see it anymore, the different set pieces, that's been completely replaced. So we're very excited about that. It gives us a little more flexibility on some of the things that we can do. And it also improves safety, which is the most important thing.
Absolutely. And it's a centennial celebration for the palace.
Yes. Actually, next season will be our centennial.
Okay.
So we're in our 99th year. I don't think that there's been a more exciting time for the palace, having these major renovations, kicking off with our season. Our partnership with Citizens Bank has now gone into its 14th year, and it just seems like everything is firing on all cylinders. We've just started a capital campaign that's just raised over $1 million in our silent phase. So we'll be talking more about that later on. And it's a really good time to be part of the Palace Theater.
Well, absolutely so. And as you said, the ticket prices are very, very competitive. Certainly a lot less expensive than Broadway. I can attest to that, having been in New York over this past weekend. But the venue is great. The sight lines from any seat in the house is incredible. And there are tickets available, I would suspect, for Rent coming up.
Yes, you can go online to palacetheater.org. You can check out our website. If you've never been there, under the buy tickets option, there is a virtual tour, and that gives you a really good idea of just how intimate a venue we are. We're 890 seats, and even the furthest seats in the balcony are only about 70 feet from the stage.
Yeah.
So you're right there. And that's something that's going to be exciting for Rent. It's a show that is going to be right in your face. It's going to make you, you know, look at these characters and deal with what they're going through. And you're going to ride this journey along with them. And I know the quality. I'm so excited for opening night, just, you know, to be able to really share this with people. And one thing that's really exciting for our dress rehearsal, Citizens Bank has purchased the dress rehearsal and has offered it to college students for free. And to get the sense of how passionate people are about this, going around to the different colleges like New Hampshire Institute of Art or Southern New Hampshire University and letting them know, hey, you can come and see Rent for free because Citizens Bank has bought a ticket for you. College students are beside themselves, and the response has been amazing. And so Thursday will be a good dress rehearsal for us, and then Friday night is going to be an amazing opening.
Wow. And so if a college student is listening right now, how are they able to obtain those tickets for Thursday?
They can. The easiest way is they could call the box office, and that's 603-668-5588. Just identify yourself as a college student, and you can get a pair of tickets. And remember to thank Citizens Bank for that, for their generosity. And if you're thinking of doing that, if you're open on Thursday night and can come, please do not hesitate because there are not many of these tickets left. And we only have about 900 of them, so make sure you come early.
Very good. Well, Chris, we have a call for you from Werner in Hopkinton. Werner, how are you?
Fine, Ken. How you been?
I'm doing well. Nice to hear from you, Werner.
Well, I've been out of work with a sciatic problem for 6 weeks.
I'm sorry to hear that.
The reason I'm calling, sitting in front of me, is the New Hampshire Musical Society presents Oklahoma at the opening of the Manchester Playhouse, now known as the Palace Theater.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Of which I was in, and so was my ex-wife.
Ah.
Know that it's 49 years ago that we, a crew of over 100, cleaned that place because Mr. Sharris had given us permission to use it and unfortunately passed away and never saw the show. But, you know, Jim Jajopoulos, who had the Oxford shop right next door to the theater, was the one that arranged it. So I was in this show. We did 20-something performances, 3 or 4 weekends, and Elton Eldridge was a man who came to town and decided he wanted to have a musical theater place and got the theater going again. So I was very proud, and I'm sitting here looking at my picture playing Will Parker.
Will
Parker.
You know,
that's the guy that got to Kansas City on a Friday.
There you go. There you go. And that was 49 years ago, huh?
On a Friday.
You still remember the music?
My wife did all the costumes, and she was also in the show with Louie. Louie Jajopoulos at that time was Allie Hakem.
Okay. Right? Yeah.
And Dorothy Stradman, who I do believe is still alive, was Lori.
Unbelievable. 49 years ago, huh?
And yeah, it was started in 1964 when they finally got this thing going.
And
so I have this program. I'm sure Chris would love to see it. He may have one in the file somewhere.
Oh, you know, I've got goosebumps right now.
Yeah.
I am so glad that you called in because coming up on our centennial, we're looking for people like you who have pieces of history of the Palace Theater because, you know, the Palace has been through, had its ups and downs, and a lot of our history has been lost. So I'm beside myself that I'm so happy that, you know, someone like you has preserved this and can be part of our centennial and we can share our rich history as we're going forward.
Well, thank you, Chris. I'd be happy to share this with you. Obviously, it's a keepsake of mine, but I'd be happy to bring it down and show it to you sometime.
Excellent. And I'm sure we can work something out and get your contact information.
Ken knows where to reach me on my business also.
All right, why don't you leave, hold on before you hang up, Werner.
I'm ready to keep talking if you want to hear more.
I'll tell you, I would, and I'd love you to call us back anytime and talk about it. But I'll tell you what, we're coming up to a break, but hold on and give J-Dog your contact information, and we will pass it along to Chris.
Yeah, okay. You used to do my commercials.
I remember it well, Werner. I do, and I hope you're feeling better soon.
Thank you.
And get back to work.
Thank you so much.
Thanks,
Werner.
It's nice to have met you and talked with you, and I look forward to having the opportunity to bring this down and show it to you.
Very good.
Likewise.
Werner, thank you so much, and hold on and give J-Dog the information.
Sure will.
Thank you, Werner. Thanks so much for calling in. Truly appreciate it, as the Palace will be celebrating 100 years next year. And this is number 99. 100 will be next year. And tell us a little bit, Chris, before we have to wrap things up, about the rest of the schedule ahead on the Palace for 2013 and 2014.
So the entire lineup for the Citizens Bank Performing Arts Center series is right now we have Rent, which is going September 13th through October 5th. We've got Monty Python's Spamalot, which is November 1st through the 16th. We have the Nutcracker, which is we have every year, November 29th through December 1st. Christmas Carol, which is award-winning, you know, the Hippo and the Union Leader have given us a Reader's Awards every year on this, December 5th through 22nd. Then when we get a little bit further on, we've got some great titles like Xanadu. We've got Divas Through the...
Is that Xanadu on roller skates,
yes,
right?
On roller skates.
Man, yeah.
Yep. we've got Divas Through the Decade, which is an original... it's one of Carl's original shows. And it's amazing to see what he does when developing his own shows, and that's one not to miss. And then some classics like The Producers, A Chorus Line, and then another one of Carl's originals, My Mixtape, The Sound of the 80s. So we've got something for everyone this year, and I urge you, if you're looking for Broadway quality theater at, you know, local New Hampshire prices, you cannot beat the Palace Theater.
No, you cannot, and in many regards, and not only price-wise, but in terms of quality of production, and Citizens Bank, with their parking lot right across the street, makes things very convenient for people who show up at the Palace.
Absolutely. After banking hours, you know, it's a great resource for us to alleviate some of the parking issues in downtown Manchester.
Absolutely so. So convenience... price-wise and in terms of quality of production, you can't beat the Palace, and they have great youth programs as well. My youngest daughter, Melissa, was involved in their youth program for many, many years, and those productions are outstanding as well. So just so many offerings and so many. It's a vibrant place and getting better all the time.
Absolutely. You know, if someone just looks at you know, the shows that we have going on, we've got something going on just about every single night.
Yeah.
Whether it's someone rehearsing or getting ready for another show, the lights are never off at the Palace Theater, and I think that's a good thing.
It is. It's a very active place and one of the great treasures in the state of New Hampshire. And Chris Lockwood, so glad that the Pulse and the Palace are able to team up and promote some of the things going on at the Palace Theater. It's great to have you with us, and look forward to having you on again in the not-too-distant future.
Thank you so much, and please come out and see some great theater. Rent will not disappoint, and you can get tickets at palacetheater.org or call the box office 668-5588 or swing in and see us. We're on 80 Hanover Street.
And the box office is open when? The hours of the box office? I think you're open till 7 o'clock, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes.
Yeah, Monday through Friday anyway. And or call 668-5588 or log on to their great new website, palacetheater.org. Simple as that. And you'll get all the information you need. And we'll have a segment with the good folks at the Palace Theater every other Tuesday at this time. And Chris, glad we could launch it. And thanks for all the information. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
1-866-823-1077 is our number. It's a Hot Ticket Tuesday presented by the Palace Theater, where Rent opens this Friday night. Tickets are still available.